sanitary project. I will take you to what all things you need to do. Already I have shared few of the documents related to the work that you need to carry out individually, and work in charge one has to look after the designs. I have sent you the PDF of the design and along with AutoCADs. Only AutoCADs are mentioned for few of the units. And about this presentation, I have mentioned what are the things that you need to do. Myself Nitin Deshpande would like to guide you in the sanitary project with the required components. Firstly, I need to tell you about the reports that you are going to prepare. Maybe the introductory part, the general. Mainly the concept introduces me to which village you have surveyed and what is its necessity. Basic detail, design consideration, design periods, that is 30 years that you need to take it into account, because have a design period of 30 years. So looking into this factor, I will be helping you out for designing 30 years. What is the existing sanitation condition in India, especially for the rural schemes? Field work carried out, recognized survey, okay, the initial survey that were given to you, the like population that is existing there, and the type of the system that has been adopted for the disposal of the sewage, and all that you need to incorporate. Detailed survey that you have carried out, maybe the survey that you have done is the profile levelings that you have done at different sections that you have carried out, maybe the main line and the sub main which you have done. Then the objectives of the project, I have mentioned it in my report. Then you are going to propose the designs which are required for you, maybe the population that you need to forecast. Looking into 2011 population, you need to forecast it, and our design period is 2052 that you have to design it for. That is the projected population, proposed system, design of sewer. Then we come to the main concept of design of sewage treatment plant. I think so you have surveyed it at a lower elevation, where you have might have taken 100 into 50 or maybe 100 into 80. Now you have to go with some of the components like approach channel, screen, wet well, suction pipe, design of pump, grid chamber. Okay, so this all are the reports that the work in charge to second person will be doing. The first person will be accumulating it till the objective of the project. The second person will be taking care of all these designs, he'll be collecting it and then he'll be concluding it. The conclusion needs to be written by you regarding how the project works, right? Some of the objectives that I need to mention: to provide proper sewerage system. So now you can see India is basically lagging in this sewerage system. Few of the even urban areas are having septic tank, they are not having proper sewer channels, where the sewage gets collected and it is being taken to the treatment plant for the further process of the treatment that is required. Provide separate collection system to preserve rainwater. There are no proper storm drains, so hope you can write that in your existing condition that you are going to explain it in your report. So the separate storms are done to collect only the rainwater so that the load on the treatment plant will not be more. Treat the sewage as per CPCB standards. This CPCB tells us about Central Pollution Control Board norms of New Delhi, which only talks about how you are going to restrict it for a BOD value of less than 20 mg per liter and COD of 250 mg per liter to utilize the treated effluent for irrigation purpose. If that sewage can be used as an treated sewage that can be used within its limits as per CPCB, then you can use it, because you know there is a need for the water during peak period. So that time you can supply the water for domestic condition and agricultural activities even can nurture by this particular condition. Study of existing condition of sanitation. So these are the few things that you have to remember. You have to see what is the existing condition and the design period. So I have mentioned it here. So coming to the basic part, so you already studied what is population forecasting. Population forecasting talks about the three methods that you are going to implement. Arithmetic increase method talks about Pn is equal to P0 plus Nx bar. It is some uniform rate that has been adopted. Geometrical increase method, its formula is Pn is equal to P0 1 plus r by 100 raised to n, where r is equal to growth rate. Incremental increase method talks about pn is equal to p naught plus nx bar plus n plus 1 by 2 into y bar. So those who are following this particular design, they have to do all these three methods and compare it with natural growth rate method, a simple method which has been again complexed with the geometric increase method. You have to check what is the growth rate of India, and according to that you are going to design. So everything has been mentioned here, just go through this. So now coming to the main part, for me, we need to forecast the population for a period of 2052. Now, why it is 2052? The design period, not only we must think about the present condition, we have to think about the future into account. So the present year is 2020, base period will be 2020 plus 2 years, and the design period will be 2022 plus 30 years, that is 2052, that you need to design.